Today I'm going to show you how to use a calculator to find the following values. First off, I want to show you the calculator that we're going to use for this demonstration, and it's the TI30XIIS. We're using this calculator because it's the calculator that is available for you in the math lab, and this is the one that most of the instructors suggest. So everything that I show you is going to be on this calculator today. The first problem they ask you to find the values is 7 to the third power. And how you put this in the calculator is you would actually type in 7, and you can use this little key right here. This is called the caret key. And so when you hit 7, you should see 7 in the screen. And then when you hit the caret key, it's like a little up arrow. And then you would hit 3 and then enter. And you can actually see it in your calculator when you type it. And when you hit enter, it will give you 343. So that's how you enter 7 to the third in your calculator. Now I'm going to write the answer, 343. And then we're going to go to the next example, 4 to the negative 2 power. So if I want to put that in my calculator, I'm going to clear out what I had last, and I'm pressing 4. And again, I'm going to hit the caret key. And to put the negative 2, I'm going to use this little symbol right here that's that negative symbol. So to the negative 2 power. And when I press enter, it's going to give me a decimal. Now, most of the time, they want you to keep it in fraction form. If they want the decimal, you can just write this answer down. But if you want to write it as a fraction instead of a decimal, you can hit second, this little blue button here. And where it says F to D, that gives it from a fraction to a decimal or a decimal to a fraction. It goes either way. And when I press enter, it gives me that decimal in fraction form, which is 1 over 16. So I'm going to write my answer in as 1 over 16 for my answer number 2. Now to plug in an e to the fifth power, that's our second or our third problem, is e to the fifth. The E button is located in blue on top of the LN button. So to get to that blue button, you have to first hit second and then your LN, and your E to the something will come up on the computer, on the calculator screen. So since I wanted to put in E to the fifth, I'm going to put in a 5 in the parentheses and close that parentheses. And when I hit enter, it will give me that value. Now, this value is always going to be an approximation, so let's approximate it to two decimal places. So I have 148.41, and I'm going to round that to the hundredths place. So since this 3 is not 5 or bigger, that 41 is just going to stay a 1 right here. So I'm going to have 148.41, and that's rounded to the hundredths place. So that's what I put as my answer. So those are how you put exponents in your calculator. Now let's move on to logarithms. There's a couple of buttons that you can see on your calculator that says logarithms. The first one is log, the L-O-G, that's your common log. So anytime you see the word log, you can just push that L-O-G button and then the number, and you can put it just like that in your calculator. So I'm going to go to my calculator, I'm going to clear it out, and I'm going to press log of 8, because that's the one we wanted to do. Press enter, and I'm going to approximate this to two decimal places as well. So this is approximately 0.90. The next example is ln of 6. I'm going to do the same thing, except instead of pressing log, I'm going to press the ln button. So I'm going to clear this one out and press ln of 6. Close my parentheses and press enter. And again, I'm going to approximate this to two decimal places. So this is approximately 1.79. So let's look at all these buttons that we found. We found the common log button, the natural log, and remember, second ln is your e to the some power. So those are the three buttons that we found, and they're right at the very top. Now continuing with our page, log of negative 3, let's see what this does. When I press log and then I press my negative button, remember that's at the bottom, negative 3, and I'm closing my parentheses. Remember, you can see what you type in. And when I press enter, I get domain error. And that's because this does not exist, Because the domain of a logarithm, remember, is the positive real. So it goes from 0 to positive infinity. And so if you include negative values inside of the argument of the logarithm, you're going to get this error message every time. So anytime it tells you the domain error, that just means it does not exist. And that's because of the domain of the logarithm. The next thing we're going to talk about is the change of base formula. I mentioned that the log was the common log and the ln was your natural log. So if you don't have a common log or a natural log, like this one has base 3, remember a common log has a base 10 automatically and the natural log has a base e. So if you have anything other than those two, you can't put it in your calculator without using the change of base formula. And your change of base formula is going to be log of the bigger number, the argument on top, and then log of the base on bottom. So I'm going to first rewrite this in the change of base formula, and then I'm going to enter it into my calculator. So this is going to be log of 75 divided by log of 3. So when I put that in my calculator, I'm going to clear this out first, and I'm going to have log of 75, close my parentheses, divided by log of 3. Close my parentheses again, and then press enter. It is very important for you to close your parentheses off on your 75 before you hit the divided by problem, or divided by, and then the other log, or your answer will not come out right. So that approximated to two decimal places is 3.93. Because the number after the 2 is 5 or bigger, it's going to make this 2 go up to 3. So my answer is 3.93 approximately. Let's try that again. We have another problem. It's kind of similar to what the change of base formula is in your calculator. So we're going to try this again, and this time we're going to use ln. So I'm going to clear this one out, and I'm going to press ln of 3.58 and then divide by ln of 7. So I have my ln in my calculator. I'm going to have 3.98. Notice that I close my parentheses. I'm sorry, it's 5.8. Sorry. And so notice that I close my parentheses on the 3.58 before I hit my divided by button. And I'm just going to start that one over because I messed up. So I had ln of 3.58, close my parentheses, then I'm going to hit my divided by button and hit ln again. And then 7. Close my parentheses again, and my approximation this time to two decimal places is going to be 0.66, because the second decimal, 1 over from that second decimal place is a 5. It's going to make that 5 go up 1 to 6, and that's going to be the approximation to two decimal places. Now, the last thing that we're going to put in our calculator is number 9. And number 9 is similar to our compound interest formula. Now, it's very important that you know how to put this in your calculator correctly, because if you do anything incorrectly in the calculator, it's going to make your entire answer wrong. So I'm going to clear out everything that we've seen, and I'm going to input this into my calculator exactly how I see it on this paper. So the first thing I'm going to type in is 5. Then I'm going to open my parentheses and type in 1 plus 0.05 divided by 2. And then I close my parentheses. So everything that you see right here is 5, open parentheses, 1 plus 0.05 divided by 2. Close my parentheses. Now everything else is raised to a power. So when I raise it to a power, I'm going to hit that up button, that caret key. Now, since I have more than one number on the outside in my exponent, I'm going to use parentheses. Even though it's not there, unless you're going to put 14, you need to put parentheses 2 times 7, close parentheses. If you don't do that, if you just put a caret key and then 2 times 7 without the parentheses, it's only going to raise it to the second power. And then it will multiply that whole value times 7. So to get the right value in the exponent, you have to put both numbers in parentheses. And when I hit enter, my approximation to two decimal places is going to be 7.06, one value to, or one unit to the right of the 6 is a 4. It's not big enough, so the 6 is going to stay the same. So this is the approximation of two decimal places. So this is how you use your calculator to find values in exponentials and logarithmic functions.